We all know about oil drilling, but there are way more ways to get fossil fuels out of the ground. So let's drink that milkshake. Hey everybody, thank you for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. Fossil fuels are a worldwide essential resource. We use coal, petroleum, natural gas, propane, diesel, kerosene, and so on for manufacturing, fuel, power, heat. Honestly, they're just part of everything that we do almost every day. Fossil fuels are made from the decomposed remains of tiny plants and animals, which died hundreds of millions of years ago in ancient oceans that covered our planet. These organisms sank to the bottom where anaerobic bacteria digested the biomass before the heat and pressure of the Earth's crust pressed on them for millions of years. Today, we extract these substances in various ways for so many uses. Again, I cannot even list them all here. Plastics, shipping, construction, power. They would take way too long. The most popular fossil fuel used today is oil. The first oil well was drilled in 1859 and could extract 800 gallons of crude a day, way more than anyone saw the need for at the time. But in January 2015, humans produced about 94 million barrels of oil every day. Most of US oil doesn't come from the Middle East, but from homegrown production. We only imported 27% of our overall usage of oil in 2014, the lowest since 1985. What we do import comes mainly from Latin America and Canada. The reason we've become an oil producer and not a sole oil consumer is hydraulic fracturing in North Dakota, Texas, Oklahoma, and New Mexico. This controversial fossil fuel extraction practice uses lots of water and fluid to fracture the Earth's crust, releasing the oil and natural gas trapped in the ground. Fracking accounted for 49% of oil and 54% of natural gas production in February of 2015. As oil barrel prices drop, profitability decreases though, and fewer rigs are constructed. Whether that's good or bad depends on your perspective, but if you think it sounds like a complicated process, you should check out tar sands and shale. Tar sands aren't like tar pits from the Flintstones or the Land Before Time, but rather they're 90% clay, sand, and water. They're often called oil sands or bituminous sands because the other 10% is valuable bitumen, a natural form of petroleum hydrocarbons. Normally, petroleum is a liquid, but this isn't only because it's mixed with the clay and the sand. In warm weather, a tar sand is a semi-solid and the color of good gardening soil. It can freeze with cold temperatures just like regular earth. How stuff works, says Alberta, Canada, may contain as many as 300 billion barrels of oil trapped in their tar sands. But once it's separated, that oil burns the same as oil from anywhere else. Shale oil is the name for a sedimentary rock with kerogen trapped inside it. Kerogen is a hydrocarbon-rich fuel source alternative to petroleum or natural gas. Kerogen is like fossil fuels, but it can also be a result of ancient land plants or the undersea plankton fossils I mentioned. If we left shale oil alone for millions more years of geologic pressure and temperature, the oil shale would eventually become simply oil, which we could drill out of the ground. It's kind of like teenage oil. No one is that patient though, so instead we've learned to extract, refine, and turn shale oil into many petroleum products. Obviously, from a business perspective, the more traditional forms of extraction are best. Drilling and mining are still very popular. Drilling involves finding a pocket of oil and natural gas, drilling into it, and extracting it for refining and processing. It's done on land and also in the ocean. It's not as difficult to extract as fracking, sands, or shale. According to the World Coal Association, we mine over 6 billion metric tons of coal annually, mostly in China, the USA, India, Australia, and South Africa, and that's done both at the surface and also in underground mines. Many people and governments around the world object to the burning of fossil fuels because hydrocarbons release carbon dioxide and other greenhouse gases, which contribute to climate change and global warming. Some countries like Costa Rica, therefore, have completely forsaken fossil fuels for renewable energy like wind and solar. But how do you feel about all this? Do you want to know more about any of these fossil fuel technologies or others? Tell us about it down in the comments, and none of these fossil fuels happen in a vacuum. Remember that saying, when a butterfly flaps its wings or whatever, it causes a hurricane wherever? That's true when it comes to pollution too. China's pollution is affecting more than just China. So check out Julia's video on that here.
According to EU air quality standards, less than 1% of China's pollution breathes clean air daily. It's so bad, it's even been compared to what a nuclear winter might look like.
And thank you for watching DNews today. Have a good one.